So look at the end fire array antenna, which is now mounted up on the transmitting mount, and we are moving it, and here we are getting the values of corresponding radiations. Look like this, okay? And those values I have taken from the experiment is looks like this. The observation table from here, 0° to 360° rotation is there, and corresponding received signal strength will be also measured in dB microvolt. Okay, and that values will be look like this, and the normalized value, how we can calculate it? Like the maximum value is here 51.9, and the 51.9 is being subtracted from the all the received signal strength values. Like at first 51.9 minus 51.9, that is give 0, and that is normalized value is 0. And again if I am subtracting 48.1 minus 51.9, what do you get? That is minus 3.8, and like this. So we can calculate all the normalized value, and we can see that at 90° the subtraction will be maximum, that is minus 16.9 will be there. Okay, and another value that we get, that 33.1 at 270°, that is also giving us the maximum deviation or deflection. We can say that what is that value? That is 33.1 minus 51.9, that is actually how much? Minus, this is 8 and this is 18. So minus 18.8, that is the maximum actually deflection here, minus 18.8. So that minus 18.8, that is the maximum deflection. So we have to divide this divisions accordingly. The 20 division equals to 20 division equals to 18.8. So 1 division equals to how much? 18.8 by 2, 20. Okay, so that will give around, that means 1.8, that is 0.944, like this. Okay, so from there, that means all this one will be 0.9 minus 94, that will also 0.-94. So minus 3 dB, how long? If we take 1 1 1 1, and this around here actually, so at 0°, that is the maximum value. So we can plot like this is the 0° value, and the next value is minus 3.8. that means the next value directly comes to this end, this point. Look at this, that 0° value will be there, and minus 3 dB value is there, as it looks like this. This is minus 3.8 and this is minus 4.3. so minus 3.8, that means that will directly comes to this point, so 0 to this. Okay, and the next value is minus 4.3, that is 4.3 around here. Okay, so you can plot it like this. And there is look like this, and here you can get like this. like this kind of figure will be there. So we can definitely figure out that the broadside array and the end fire array look like this. This is the end fire array at which 0 degree is maximum and 90 degree is minimum. And for this broadside array, look at this, this 90 degree is maximum and 0 degree is minimum. So this is the basic difference between broadside array antenna and end fire antenna. But their mounting will be looks like almost similar, but their radiation patterns will be different. So that's it.